people know you from so many different things. What would you say is number one for the people at home who are trying to put it together?
Oh man, I think the number one thing would have to be a couple of movies called Pitch Perfect 1, Pitch Perfect 2, and Pitch Perfect 3.
They're fantastic. I always say that that is the movie, without fail. There are guys that are like, yeah, I don't think I'd like that. And then they watch it. Yeah. And then they say, that was a damn good movie. All of them were fantastic. And in fact, I think you said once that all the ladies from that movie would do as many as they could do.
100%. I mean, we still have this like group text that we're all on. It's like the Bella's group chain. And we're always like checking in on one another. And we always joke around that we would be like really old, like in a retirement home, like singing a cappella, walking around with like our walkers and all that stuff. So, oh my God. Yeah. We would do them forever if the fans wanted them, for sure. I mean, it's so cool to get to play a character that many times anyway, over the course of like how many years that we did. Yeah. So to play it when I'm an old lady. Yeah. I would gladly do that. It'd be great.
That's going to be a good feeling, though, when you have a movie with a fan base. You know, even though you got like 3 projects currently in the works, if things go bad, you could always just keep doing Pitch Perfect movies for the rest of your life.
I could. I definitely could. I mean, as long as, yes, if the fans wanted it, for sure. And the scripts, you know, were hopefully, you know, good and everything. But that definitely, it's nice to know that people still love those movies. And we had no idea that they were going to be as big of a hit as they were. So it's just awesome to see that people are still fans of those projects. So yeah, people say, right. Excuse me to me all the time still when I see them like in Target and stuff.